Hi, my name is Alex, and in this tutorial, we'll look at a number of steps in Python code to extract, transform, and load some Excel-sourced data. The tutorial, in this example, simplifies the ETL process by using a straightforward Excel file as the data source system. This tutorial aims to convey the underlying ETL concepts in a clear and understandable manner, focusing on the fundamental steps of extraction, transformation, and loading. While this tutorial serves as an introductory guide only, a more advanced tutorial showcasing extracting data from more complex systems like PostgreSQL database will follow shortly. As for the code itself, you'll be able to get it from my GitHub page, link to which I will leave in the description below. Having said all that, let us jump straight into the code.
We begin by importing the necessary libraries. Pandas as PD to work with data in tabular form, matplotlib.pyplot as PLT to create visualizations, and numpy as NP for mathematical operations. Step 1. Reading the source Excel file. The code begins by reading an Excel file using the readExcel function from the pandas library and the file path specified. The straightforward Excel file substitutes a more complex type of data source such as an API or SQL database. Step 2. Performing transformations. Transformation number 1. Convert name to uppercase. The product column string values are converted to uppercase using the str.upper method. This promotes consistency in how the string values are represented by ensuring uniformity of the product name's formatting and thus increasing the ease of readability. Transformation number 2. Detect outliers based on the quartile method and identify isolate negative values. Outliers, which are data points significantly deviating from the majority, are identified using the quartile method. The code calculates quartile values with Q1 representing the 25th percentile and Q3 representing the 75th percentile. The code also calculates the interquartile range, IQR. Next, it defines the lower and upper bounds. The code then proceeds to define the range for outliers, followed by specifying the parameter needed for detection of negative values. Next, outliers and negative values are isolated and stored in a separate data frame named outliers_and_negative using the pandas.concat method. Finally, we remove the identified outliers and negative values from the original data frame DF before conducting any subsequent analysis or transformation steps using the df.drop function. Apart from identifying outliers, it is important to detect and isolate negative numbers in columns where positive values are expected, as negative values can indicate data entry errors or anomalies that require investigation and correction for the sake of data integrity and accurate analysis. This section wouldn't be complete without a quick sense check to verify that outliers and negative values have been removed from the data frame DF. Transformation number 3. Impute empty values in the quantity sold column with the column min. The code creates a new column called imputed and fills it with empty strings to begin with. It then identifies the rows where quantity sold is null using the loc function and sets the corresponding imputed value to x for the ease of identification of the imputed values later. The min of quantity sold column is calculated using the min method. Next, empty values are substituted with the column min using the .fillNA method, whilst the min values are being rounded up to 2 decimal places using numpy.seal method. Finally, we run a quick confirmation on whether the transformation steps have been applied successfully. A quick word of warning here. Imputing values should always be an informed decision, as it carries the risk of introducing ambiguity if too many values are imputed, potentially impacting the integrity and accuracy of the data analysis results. Transformation number 4. Calculate and add the total revenue column. The total revenue column is calculated by multiplying the quantity sold column with the cost per unit column. Adding and calculating the total revenue column is a common request from stakeholders, as it provides a comprehensive measure of the revenue generated by each product, enabling better insights and decision making regarding overall business performance. Transformation 5. Calculate and add the percentage of total revenue column. The total for revenue is calculated as the sum of values in the total revenue column for all product rows. The percent of total revenue column shows percent contribution of each product towards the total for the column, and it's calculated by dividing each product's total revenue by the total revenue and multiplying by 100. Next, the values are rounded to two decimal places using the dot round method. Rounding up decimal points not only promotes ease of interpretation of the figures by providing concise and readable values, but it also helps decrease the size of the data frame, making it more manageable and efficient for analysis and visualization tasks. Finally, a quick spot check assures us that the percent of total revenue column has been added to the data frame as specified. Transformation number 6. Sort the data frame in descending order based on the total revenue column. In this step, the data frame is sorted in descending order based on the total revenue using the sort values method. This allows for easy identification of the best and worst performing products immediately. In addition, the visual impact of the sorted data frame is translated into the bar chart, making it easier to identify revenue disparities across the visualized range. As always, we perform a quick sense check to verify the status of the applied transformation. Transformation number 7, adding the total row to the data frame. A new data frame named Total Row is created to represent the total values. It contains the sum of the quantity sold and the total revenue columns respectively. The latter utilizes the total revenue variable defined in the previous step as its aggregation mechanism. The addition of the total row promotes ease of interpretation and understanding of the aggregation of the key values in the data frame. The pd.concat function is used then to concatenate original data frame DF and total row data frame. Finally, the concatenated data frame is reindexed. Our last step for this transformation is to run a quick check to verify the results of the applied transformation.
Transformation number 8, reorder columns for better readability. This step ensures that the columns are arranged in a logical and coherent manner for better data presentation. In this particular case, the column imputed is placed at the end of the data frame using indexing. By having moved the imputed column at the end of the data frame, we maintain the overall visual coherency of the formatting with related columns grouped together.
Step 3. Saving the data frame and chart to the output Excel file. First, we assign the output Excel file save location to a variable called output file. Next, we create a save to Excel code block based on the pandas.excelwriter method. We save the final version of the data frame DF with all its transformations applied to a sheet named data using the DF to Excel function. Next, we are saving the outliers _and_negative data frame to a separate sheet called outliers. Here, we activate the data sheet to place a chart object in it. We create the chart object on the data sheet using the .addChart function method. The next step is to specify chart categories and value ranges respectively using the .addSeries method. Finally, We customize the chart by adding a chart name, axis values, and the legend. Having applied basic customization to our chart object, we specify the cell H1 on the sheet date as the location where we want the chart to be placed. Now that our code is complete and appears to be functioning as intended, let's inspect the output Excel file's content. By looking at the source file and the output file side by side, we observe that the transformation logics applied have worked. Although the raw source file contained several so common in the daily life of a data analyst issues, yet throughout the application of the transformation logics, it has been transformed into a concise and error-free snapshot, allowing for easy identification of the best and worst performing products, revenue disparities, and aggregation of the key values in the data frame. You are now equipped with a basic understanding of ETL concept and how implementing simple data transformations can enhance data quality, detect outliers, handle missing values, visualize data effectively, and ultimately help leverage data as a means for forming and advocating corrective actions and decision making.